myself Krishnakant. In this video, we are going to solve gate question from the year 2006. This question belongs to the subject communication from the chapter of analog communication systems. And this belongs to the topic of amplitude modulation. So this is a linked question where two questions are given. So you can observe the question on the screen. The common data given for this is, consider the following amplitude modulated signal FM suffix B x AM of t equal to 10 into 1 plus 0.5 sine 2 pi FMT into cos 2 pi FCT. The first question is, the average sideband power for the given AM signal is dash. Option A 25, option B 12.5, option C 6.25 and option D 3.125. So let us solve this question. The given AM signal is, the time domain equation he has given, x AM of t equal to 10 into 1 plus 0.5 sine 2 pi FMT into cos 2 pi FCT. So what he is asking? He is asking the sideband, average sideband power. So we know in AM signal, we will be transmitting two signals. One is what? One is carrier signal. So if you multiply 1 this first part, you will get what? Cos 2 pi FCT, which is nothing but the carrier signal. And the second one is what? Sin 2 pi FM into cos 2 pi FCT, that is the modulated signal. So in AM we are transmitting these two signals. So carrier signal is this part, carrier frequency, and the second part is what? Is this sideband. What we need? We need the message signal. Message signal will lie in what? In the sidebands. So the total power of AM consists of how many parts? We know the formula, PC into 1 plus nu square divided by 2. In this total power, it will be containing how many parts? Two parts. The first one is carrier power and the second one is what? Sideband power. So what he is asking? He is asking the sideband power. So what is the sideband power? It is nothing but PC into nu square divided by 2. What is PC? So if you compare this with the standard equation, which is nothing but AC into 1 plus nu sine 2 pi FMT into cos 2 pi FCT. If you compare this equation with the standard form of AM signal, time domain equation. So what are the conclusions we will make? AC is 10 and modulation index mu equal to 0.5. So in order to know the sideband power, what we need? We need nu value and PC value. So nu value has given 0.5 and what you need PC power is nothing but AC square by 2R into nu square divided by 2. Here AC we know from the given equation, what we don't know R. So in question he didn't mention anything about resistance, na? So we are free to take the normalized power which you will get when we take R equal to 1 ohm. But if in question, if he has mentioned some value of resistance, then you have to take that value of R. So I think we are clear. If resistance value is not given in the question, na, we are supposed to take the normalized power which we will get by taking R equal to 1 ohm. So what you will get the sideband power is nothing but AC square mu square by 4, which is nothing but 1 by 4 into 10 square is 100 into 1 by 4. If you calculate this, you will be getting 6.25 you will be getting. 6.25 watts. So if you see 6.25, which is in option C. So option C is what? Option C is the correct answer. So the main trick is what? You have to know what value of resistance you have to take. So not given any value of resistance. That is why we have taken as normalized power as R equal to 1 ohm. So the conclusion for this question is not, the sideband power we got is 6.25 watts. So whenever linked questions are given, linked questions, 2 or 3 questions, then always make it a habit to write the conclusion of one question. Because if linked questions are given, that will be useful to solve the next question. No need to solve again that value. Okay. That will help us. Now let us see the other question, which you can see on the screen. The AM signal gets added to a noise with power spectral density given in the figure below. The ratio of average sideband power to mean noise power would be option A 25/8 NOB, option B 25/4 NOB, option C 25/2 NOB, and option D 25/NOB. So what he has given? He has told that EM signal is affected with noise and the noise is having a power spectral density like this. This is FC, FC plus B, FC minus B. Whenever positive frequencies are there in communication, there will be negative frequencies also. Minus FC, minus FC plus B, minus FC minus B. The x-axis is what? Frequencies. And y-axis is what? Power. He has given us N0/2. So the first conclusion is what? First question conclusion. The sideband power is 6.25 watts. Now what he is asking? He is asking the ratio of sideband power to noise power. So sideband power, you know what we need? We need noise power. So in order to find noise power, what he has given? He has given the power spectral density. So what is power spectral density? It will tell how power is distributed to different frequencies. What is the density of power in different frequencies? That is power spectral density. And if you want the total power, now what you have to add? You have to add the all powers given to individual frequencies. That is why the noise power will be getting by integrating the power spectral density for the entire range of frequencies. Means if you add all the power given to individual frequency components, then what you'll get? You'll get the total power of noise. So here, this is what symmetrical signal. If you want the power under this frequency, means you need this area and this area. You can see these two are symmetrical. So I can write twice of positive frequencies area. So in positive frequencies, again, how much area is there? This and this. This triangle is having the base of B and height of N0/2. Similarly, this triangle is also having base of B and height of N0/2. So same area. So that is why I am writing what? 2 into area under one triangle. That is 4 into, what is area under this triangle? Half into, the base is B into height is N0/2. So the power you will be getting, power of noise, noise power you will be getting what? N0/B. So now you got this sideband power from the first question, which is 6.25. Noise power from the power spectral density you got as N0/B. So this is the answer. But if you see in options, he has given us what? 25/. Means what you have to do? You have to make this 625 as 25, which you can do. 25 25s are 625 and 25 4s are 100. 25/4 N0B is our answer. So if you see option B, option B is our answer. Thank you. Thanks for watching.